Excuse me, Fräulein Wolf. I could not leave the room without paying you my compliments. I'm sure you do not remember me. My name is August Schmidt.
But I do remember you. It was at Mrs. Lauder's in London, wasn't it?
Yes. You played Brahms' violin concerto.
How lovely of you to remember. And you were with an English woman. Was she your wife?
Miss Wolf, may I present my colleague from America, Mr. Tyler Whitney? Herr Whitney, Miss Anna Wolf.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch the name.
Tyler Whitney. Have we met before?
I seem to remember hearing of a Mr. Whitney years ago in New York. You were trying to raise money to start a revolution in Cuba, isn't that right?
Mexico, and it wasn't me. It must have been someplace else that we met.
Herr Whitney is well known as a champion of freedom and justice in countries other than his own. But please, don't let us interrupt your dinner.
Not at all. You're both very kind. One does get so bored on these long journeys. Good evening. Do you know, when I saw you in London, I thought you were English.
Not really.
Yes, really.
My wife is English. Perhaps because of this.
It's more than that. It's the way you dress, the way you carry yourself. And of course, you speak English so beautifully. I would never have believed you were German.
Is that so? But really, Miss Wolf, your own English is also very good.
Oh, I could go on talking like this forever. But I'm so tired. I can hardly keep my eyes open.
I do wish you could go on talking forever.
Good night, Herr Schmidt.
Good morning, Herr Schmidt. I hope all that shouting didn't wake you up last night.
Shouting? What shouting?
Guess not. Herr Schmidt, are you having lunch alone?
As a matter of fact, I'm waiting for a lady.
Have a nice wait.
Ah, Miss Wolf. Please, let me help you.
Oh, thank you.
Are you comfortable? Yes, I am so glad. Everybody wanted to sit in your seat. I've been like a soldier fighting them away.
Oh, really?
I would not let anybody sit here. What shall we order? Shall we get some wine?
That would be lovely.
I think good red wine, yes? Oh, forgive me, perhaps you would like something lighter?
My father drank red wine and I'm afraid I picked up the habit. I know it's not very ladylike.
Nonsense. We will be able to share a bottle. I hope I will not get drunk.
Why?
Oh, I'm turning into a happy little devil, especially when I am surrounded by a beautiful lady.
You are a charmer.
Isn't she enchanting? That violinist, Miss Wolf? She seems to be getting on rather well with Herr Schmidt. Not her type, I would have thought. Rather a surprise to see Herr Schmidt here. One would think he'd have his hands full back in Germany, what with his factories stepping up production and all that. Such an industrious people, the Germans. I wonder what business he has in the East.
Vienna. But didn't you say you were going to Constantinople?
Yes, but my plans have changed. Business.
Must you really get off in Vienna?
You make me feel very sorry to do so, madame.
I was looking forward to enjoying your company for the whole journey.
The piano is a little bit more difficult.
Yeah. Yes. Aber Herr Schmidt, ich bin wirklich daran interessiert, was Sie machen geschäftlich. What is your business anyway? You make it sound so mysterious.
I'm afraid you would find it very boring. But without going into detail, I will say that my work here is not only commerce, and that in my own small way, I'm doing my part for the fatherland. I have drunk too much wine. I am a little bit dizzy. But you also have drunk, Fräulein Wolf. I am impressed.
I know, I don't show it.
Shall we have our coffee in the smoking car?
That would be lovely.
Shall we sit here? I think this will be more comfortable, don't you?
I have eaten so much I could just lie down on one of these couches and go to sleep.
Go right ahead. I will wake you when we reach Constantinople.
I thought you were getting off in Vienna.
Ach yes, I had forgotten. Oh, here comes the waiter.
Nur Zucker, bitte. Zwei Stück.
Ah, you like it sweet.
Fräulein Wolf, it is a privilege to meet so talented an artist. My name is Kronos.
Your Excellency, you do me a great honor.
My car is equipped with a piano. I wonder if you would do me the favor of joining me in a duet. It will help pass the time on this rather long journey.
What a splendid idea!
Shall we say 3 o'clock?
I shall count the minutes until then. Good day.
Is it very tiresome, your business in Vienna?
Oh, well, you know, you always hope that a man will keep his word. When he does not, one hates to lose a good bit of business, but man kann nicht anders.
Also dann kommt Ihr Geschäft nicht zustande? Ist es abgesagt?
I too studied music in my youth. If I may say so, I was not without promise. Alas, life had other plans for me.
We are none of us free to choose our own destiny, Herr Schmidt.
Ah, but when you play, Madame, you make all of us feel that we are free and that we can fly with wings.
Oh, I'd better get ready for the concert now.
I will be in the front row.
You're very kind, Herr Schmidt.
Please, call me August.